This is example number 3 of a shunt generator. Again, this is somewhat a tricky question, but an easier one. Tricky thing here, first of all, is the flux per pole is given as 2.895 megalines. First thing. Another thing which is given by looking at the question and by drawing the figure of this, we understand. So this is my generator. EG. Load RL is given as 10 ohm, this one, and our shunt is also given to us as 200 ohm. This is EG. RA is also given at 0.04 ohm here in the generator only. Generator only, I am saying. So it is given that it's a 4 pole waveform 750 rpm shunt generator with a series resistance and shunt resistance as 0.04 and 200 ohm. It is having 720 conductors and the flux per pole is 2.895 megalines. And if the load resistance RL is 10 ohm, we have to find the terminal voltage VT. So, how to do this question first of all? First of all, we have to convert this flux per pole, which is given megalines, to the Weber. So, megalines are converted into Weber by multiplying it by 10 to the power negative 8. So, pi per pole is equals to 2.895 megalines is equals to 10 to the power negative 6. This will be in lines now into 10 to the power negative 8. That is 2.895 into 10 to the power negative 2 Webers. This is the first trick which is already solved. You have to multiply it by 1 into 10 to the power negative 8 for converting it from lines or megalines to Weber. First thing. Second thing is that even though we can find E, G, we cannot find VT directly. Why? We will find EG first of all. EG is equals to pi Z N P by 16 A. We know phi, that is now 2.895 into 10 to the power negative 2 Webers. Z is given to you, that is 720 conductors. N is given to you, that is 750 rpm. P, number of poles are also given to you. 60 is a constant, no issues. A is the number of parallel paths. Actually, this is a waveform. A is equals to 2. So we can find the EG. Let's see how much EG is coming. Phi is again 2.895 into 10 to the power negative 2 into Z is your 720 multiplied by N is 750 multiplied by number of poles P is 4 divided by 60 into A is 2 here because it's a waveform machine. So EG after solving this much is coming to be 521 volts. Till now we have found EG. We will write EG over here. EG is equals to 521. for our future reference. Now, what is asked in this question? That to find Vt, Vt is equals to Eg minus Ia Ra, and Ra is given to you, Eg is now available, but Ia is equals to Ish plus Il. I cannot find I shunt because terminal voltage is not given to me. Even though I cannot find IL directly, but I need to have IA. This is the second check in the question. Then how to find the IA? Just think what to do now. Maybe some might have got the idea, but when those who have not got the idea will do that. Rather than finding I, SH and IL separately, if we are able to find IA directly, then this question is solved. So, how to do that now? By looking at the figure, we can see that this arc shunt and this is in parallel. So I can have the R equivalent of arc shunt and RL, R equivalent of arc shunt, which is in parallel with R load, is how much? Arc shunt is 200 into 10 divided by 200 plus 10, this is coming out to be 200 by 21. This is the parallel combination of R equivalent. I can remove this for a sake. And I can say this R equivalent now has become 200 by 21. Is this possible now? Now I have become this thing as a series generator, almost as a series generator, just for sake of the question. Now IA is flowing from here to here. Now this is not R shunt now. This is not R shunt and none. Now this current is I load or ISH. This is IA only now. We will be able to find the IA directly. How? Now this and this RA is on series now. So R total would be how much? R equivalent this plus of your RA how much it would be 0.4 plus the 200 by 21 0.04 plus 200 by 21 and this is almost 2084 by 210. 2084 divided by 210. So I got R equivalent. So now I can find IA. How? IA would be the total terminal voltage, that is 521, divided by this much of total resistance, that is 2084 divided by 210. This is the total current which is going in this direction now. This IA will come out to be 52.5 amperes. So I can put it here from this equation. Eg already is there, 521. Sorry, this was Eg, not Vg. Eg minus of this much, which is Ia is now 52.5, multiplied by your Ra is 0.04. It was 521 minus this into this is 21 amp, that's 21 volts. So your Vt is equals to 500 volts is the answer. So this is the way, this is also a water trick question I did. Rather than finding I shunt and IL separately, I found IA directly and I have solved this question in this manner. So those who have followed this question, it's okay. Otherwise, those who have not followed, they should refer some book also to understand this thing. Another thing is that my suggestion would be when I am solving an example, so rather than me seeing the example doing, you can actually pause the video and before solving, you do the solving, so that if you are able to do that, it's well and good, it's very good, so that you will be able to understand different type of question differently, and that will make your skills better. And if you are not able to understand after two or three times, then you follow the video, then it will be a addition in your knowledge. We continue with example number 4.